Hare Krishna kids, welcome to the Damodar session. Sorry for the interruption. Today my computer is not working properly. I have some difficulty in joining. I may not be on video, but I am able to give the class. I'll be starting my PPT in few minutes. Before that, today we are starting our new stories. That is on Lord Narsingha Dev, because Narsingha's appearance is coming soon. So that's why we are doing these stories. Do you all know why did Lord Narsingha has appeared? Can each of you tell me one after the other? Okay. Why did Lord Narsingha appear? Anybody knows?
Mataji, can Subhadra say?
Yes.
Because Narsingha appeared because Hiranyakashipu was almost about to kill Prahlad.
That's why, okay.
So that's why Narsingha Dev appeared and killed Hiranyakashipu.
Oh, very nice, very nice. Okay.
Mataji, can I go?
Yes. Quickly, okay, one point. Each person, one point. We have many questions. I'll be asking you many questions, not only this one question. Today, there are so many questions that I will ask you.
Hare Krishna, Mataji, Deepak, can I go?
First, Tushita and then Deepak. Okay, Tushita, you can go first. Tushita, please go ahead.
Okay, because to save Prahlad Maharaj.
Oh, because to save Prahlad Maharaj. Very good. So, why did Lord Narsingha came like half man and half lion? Do anybody know?
Me.
Tell me. Because why?
Because he wanted to.
Okay, you don't know the answer. Okay, so somebody else who knows?
Because he said nor animal or human can kill me, but he is a half human and animal.
Animal, yes. So now moving on to this story. So, can you please off the computer now? Okay. Now moving on to the story, today's story. So that why the animals, gods, we have Hiranyakashipu, like Narsingha, we have half man and half lion. We have Matsya avatar, right? In Dashavatara, we have Matsya avatar. We have Kurma avatar. We have Varaha avatar. Why this Lord Krishna has came as, why this animal avatars we can see? Why do you think so? Why did Matsya came? Anybody knows? To save the Vedas, right? So Vedas were hidden in the water. So that's why Matsya came and to save the Vedas. Because fish can swim in the water, that's why. So then why did Kurma came? Kurma came so that Mandara Hill, they can churn the ocean, like Mandara Mountain. They can churn the ocean. That's why Kurma came. And the same way, Varaha came. Why? Because he wants to live.
Mataji, Varaha came because the third one came because he saved Mother Earth.
Yes, lifted Mother Earth. So we can see that Lord Krishna has appeared in many forms.
And
so
also.
So here we can see, because animals also, when you see like fish, you can see that Krishna's form is Matsya. And then when you see Kurma, you feel like, oh, like when you see tortoise, oh, Kurma avatar. So you can appreciate every animal also and human also. So there is no difference between animal and human, because one sense, because everybody's there is Paramatma, that's the super soul in everyone. So we have to give equal respect to animal and the human being. So in this way, we can appreciate animals also. When we see the sky, we appreciate, because Krishna, the sun is Krishna. So we should appreciate everything, that this is all because of Krishna's Krishna's energy, everything, Krishna's form and Krishna's energy. So like that, there is one more thing also. The one thing is to save the devotees. Always Krishna has came in different forms. And also we can see that in every form, everywhere, we can see Krishna's energy. So then moving on to today's story. Today we are learning about Lord Narasingha. Before that, we are going to see why actually Hiranyakashipu was so angry. What made him to be angry? Because Lord Vishnu killed his brother Hiranyaksha. Why he killed? Because Hiranyaksha was hiding earth in the ocean, and then so that's why, you know, Lord Vishnu killed Hiranyaksha. So thinking that, Hiranyakashipu thought, oh, you killed Lord Vishnu, you killed my brother, so then now I am going to kill you. I'm going to remove everything that is related to you in this earth. I'm going to cut down all the trees. I'm going to, you know, kill the brahmanas. I'm going to kill all the cows. I'm going to spoil all the scriptures, so that there is nothing related to Lord Vishnu happens in this world. So Hiranyakashipu was so angry. At the same time, we can see that Hiranyaksha's Hiranyakashipu's mother and Hiranyaksha's wife and children, everybody were, their relatives, everyone were crying. So seeing this, Hiranyakashipu was like explaining him so nicely, beautiful story. What he was explaining is that, first he was telling one thing which is correct, is like, we are not the body, we are soul. We all learn from Bhagavad Gita, right? That we are not the body, we are soul. So when we die, we are actually not going to die, we are going to go to another body. Like we learn this sloka, vasanshi jinani. What we do, it's like we are
navani grinyati naro parani asavirani bihaya jinnana atapi samyati navani
lehi. What does it mean? That we are changing our dress. We, when we are dying, it doesn't mean that we are dying. We going to go into another body. The soul is going to move into another body. We are not going to die. So that's what even Hiranyakashipu is telling here. And even he was telling to his family one nice story that what happened is, there was one king. That king was died, and his wife, what did he do? What did she do? You know, she did not bury that body, and she was keeping that body and she was lamenting there. And then the death personified God went like a small boy and went to this queen and said, this queen, that why you are worried? Why are you crying for your king's body? You know, your king's body is died, but your king's soul went to another body. You don't have to cry this. Like that he was telling. And there, what did the dead personified God did? He told one story to queen. Now we'll see, there is another story going on. First, what happened? Hiranyakashipu is telling the story of the queen, and now the dead personified God came and he was telling the story to the queen. What he was telling, we will see what he told. What happened is, there was a hunter, okay, who caught the mother bird from his nest, from her nest. What happened after he caught it, and then he mother bird is no more, right? The children were crying, the children birds were crying inside the nest, and also the husband, I mean like the father of the children were also crying, was also crying. So then what happened, you know, seeing this crying means like the father was not realizing that, you know, the mother has gone for the children, but I have to take care of my children. He was not thinking like that. He was also lamenting and crying. What happened when he cried? The hunter again came and saw that there is father bird and the children is there, the children birds are there. So then what happened? Hunter killed the father bird and everyone now. So what happened is, like, we can understand, we should not cry for the person who went. We should try to understand why this happened. What is the reason behind? How can I be relaxed from this birth, death, and old age? And this is, it's not needed to cry for what had happened. We should try to realize the spiritual thing, that we are not this body, we are soul. That is what we need to know. So if we don't know that and we keep on crying for the things, and then we, what happened? Even our turn comes and we will also die. And then again, we have to take birth. So there is no use for this birth, that present birth, what we are there, we cannot use means, then again we have to suffer. So now we can see that Hiranyakashipu knows everything, that the soul is everlasting. Soul is not dying, but the body is dying. But he don't wanted to, you know, implement that. So like we also see that we know everything, that, you know, 2 plus 2 is equal to 4 and 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. I keep on telling that, is there any use? No. When I try to, when somebody gives me money, okay, my mom gave me $2 and my dad gave me $2. So I have totally $4 and I have to go to the Walmart and I purchase one Apple bag. So then I think, oh, Apple bag is $5. So now I have, my dad gave $2 and my mom gave $2. So total $4 and I'm not having $1. So when you implement that, it's just not just addition we are learning and subtraction we are learning, A, B, C, D we are learning. It's not that, we have to implement it. How we have to use that knowledge is more important. So here Hiranyakashipu knows everything, but he's not implementing. He knows that we are not this body, we are soul. He knows everything, but what is he doing? He's fighting with Lord Vishnu only. So there is no use, right? When we are learning something, we have to implement it. So we can see that now what Hiranyakashipu did.
Mataji?
Yes.
We should learn about our soul, not the body. Because yes, we're only the soul. And when we die, the next life will turn into something else. But it's just...
Okay. Yes, yes. So Subhadra, today we are running late. I will take your realization later, okay? So then, okay, then next, what happened? Hiranyakashipu started doing tapasya to destroy Lord Vishnu. He did tapasya and he was pleasing Lord Brahma. And then what he was doing, he was standing on one toe and then he was just, you know, putting his hands up on the sky and then he was trying to do tapasya for many, many years. And, you know, his body was gone. He was completely skeleton and shell formed. And he was like, he was not dying. He was trying to keep his soul in the bones. And he was trying to be like that. He was not dying. He was not transferring his soul to another body. He was trying to capture his soul. So like that it was happening and everything became dark because of his tapasya. So then what happened? Lord Brahma came and finally Lord Brahma put some water on his body. So he came into his original form. And then now he started praying to Lord Brahma and he asked some boons. What kind of boons he asked? He asked that I should not be died any time. I should be ever living for every time. But what happened? Lord Brahma said, no, even me, I cannot live forever. I have to die. How can I give you the boon? So now Hiranyakashipu was thinking, okay, Lord Brahma don't want to give me this, but I'm going to trick him. I'm going to ask him such a way that I'm going to live forever. But he also don't know that he gave me that. So he wants to trick Brahma. And he's asking in such a nice way that I should not be killed in the day or night, inside of the building or outside of the building, on the sky. So even he's telling that I should not be killed by any living beings or any non-living beings, any weapons also I should not be killed. I should not be killed by any animals or demigods or snake, anything. I should not be killed by anything. So he was thinking, oh, now I ask this, all those things. So now he just did not leave anything. I should not kill by this. I should not kill by that. So then he was thinking, oh, now I'm safe. But Lord Brahma did not think of anything. And he said, okay, I will grant you all of this. So So now Lord Brahma had granted him. Hiranyakashipu was thinking himself in his mind that, oh, I tricked Lord Brahma now. So now I'm going to be most powerful, and I am not going to kill by anybody. So now I am going to do war against everybody. So this is the story we are stopping here for today. So what's the moral of the story? Moral of the story is not knowing that, it's just not knowing that we are not this body and we are the soul. It's not enough. It's we need to try to realize that for in everything that we should not try to do for everything, every small things, we should not be upset, you know, that, oh, okay, this is not being done, that is not being done. So we everything, just, you know, believe everything for Krishna. And we try to utilize this body for Krishna. So that is the main thing. Like how I said, example is 2 + 2 = 4, not just learning 2 + 2 = 4. We have to try to implement. When your dad and mom gives you money, how to use that, you should know about it. So like that, not just learning about things, we should implement. So here we have a diagram, like we are drawing Lord Narsingha Dev. I want everybody to take paper and pencil, start drawing this. Can you all start doing that, please? First try two, and after you just do circle. Yes.
Can I do this activity later?
Yes, if you want to do it later, that's not any problem, okay? It's not compulsory to do it right now, but if you do it, you know, Lord Narsingha Dev will be so happy, and your friends are also so motivated. Oh, Subhadra did coloring. Oh, very nice. I will also try myself. So you are preaching indirectly to your friends, you know. Not only Mataji is coming and preaching and giving the class here. If you do your activity and put it on the group, so seeing you, okay, now Tushita did a drawing very nicely. And Brinda thinks that, oh, I don't want to do today. But seeing Tushita's drawing, what happens? Oh, Tushita did. Why don't I do something for Krishna? Then Brinda also start doing her work. So this is, you are also preaching, okay? If you want to do preaching for everybody, please do it and send post on the group. Okay. Mataji, do we have time for 2 minutes? Yes, somebody speaking?
Mataji, Raghu wanted to say explanation for why Hiranyakashipu, why Narsingha Dev appeared.
Oh, okay, please tell Raga.
Hiranyakashipu wanted to kill Prahlad Maharaj, so Narsingha Dev killed Hiranyakashipu.
Very nice, Raghav. Thank you for teaching that. Thank you so much. So sweet. See, Raghav is just 4, but he's telling so much nicely. See what we can learn from Raghav, like that. We all can learn from each other so many things. So whoever is drawing from them, I'm also going to learn how to draw Narsingha now. So please do draw and post it on the group. Are you all started doing that? Can I go to the next slide?
No, Mataji. I'm not done, Mataji.
Okay. Mataji, can you start teaching the rhyme, Mataji? Is that okay?
Yeah.
They will do this drawing, and you can teach the rhyme, Mataji. That is Hiranyakshas. Varaha Avatar, Mataji. Rhyme. Okay.
Yeah, because the rhyme is a little familiar. So.
Yeah, can you do that, Mataji, while they are doing the drawing? Mataji, are you starting, Mataji?
I'm done, Mataji.
Yes.
Best of Easter.
Sarojanandini Mataji, do you want to start teaching the rhyme?
Yes. So, yeah. Hare Krishna kid, while you are drawing, we can do the rhyme. This rhyme, many of you might be familiar.
Mataji.
So we can do the rhyme. Is it okay? Can everyone repeat while you're drawing? Okay. Who's that fighting Hiranyakashipu? Okay, so this is Hiranyaksha. Mataji, is it Hiranyaksha or Hiranyakashipu?
Hiranyaksha, Mataji.
Hiranyaksha. Okay. Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha? With a long snout and two sharp gold tusks.
With a long snout and two sharp tusks.
Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha?
Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha?
Hiranyaksha and the snout.
Get the earth from the Garbhodaka.
Who lifted the earth from the Garbhodaka?
Who lifted the earth from the Garbhodaka?
Who lifted the earth from the Garbhodaka?
Varaha, Hari Hari Bol.
Varaha, Hari Hari Bol.
Varaha, Hari Hari Bol.
Keshavadrita
Shukara Rupa Rupa
Jaya Jagadisha Hare
Jaya Jagadisha
Hare Jaya Jagadisha Hare
Jaya Jagadisha Hare
Jaya
Jagadisha
Hare
Jaya Jagadisha Hare You sent one gun but your picture.
Let's do again, okay? Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha? With a long snout and two sharp gold tusks. Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha?
Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha?
Who lifted the earth from the Garbhodaka?
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 Rama, Hari Hari Bol.
Rama, Hari Bol. Jaya Jagadisha Hare.
Hare Krishna, did you all started the drawing? Are you all doing it?
Hare Krishna Mataji, it's Kaushik. Can you go to the 12th slide?
12th slide. Okay, I'll be on the 12th slide. And Mataji, can you teach this sloka, Mataji? Yes. Sure, Mataji.
Mataji?
Yes?
Are we going to do the Dashavatara or chapter 14, text 27?
Chapter 14, text number 27.
Mataji, yes? Shubhadra knows this shloka. We learned it from somewhere.
We will do it still sometimes, and then you can, when you break, go to the break room. We will break and then we will recite, okay? First, let's do the shloka, one line together. Please repeat after me. Brahmano hi
प्रतिष्ठाहम्
अमृतस्
अमृतस्
काव्ययस्य च
ब्रह्मणो हि
प्रतिष्ठाहम्
अमृतस्याव्ययस्य च
Shubhadra go.
Yes, Shubhadra, please go ahead.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to share my screen. Can you see my screen?
Not yet, Mataji. Yes, Mataji. Now. Can you see the shloka?
Okay, you can go ahead, Shubhadra.
Brahmano hi pratishtaham. Amritasya vayasya cha. Who's that fighting with Hiranyaksha? The long snout and two sharp curled tusks. Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha? Who lifted the earth from the Govardhaka? Who lifted the earth from the Govardhaka? Varaha Hari Bol Keshava Drita Shukarupa Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare Jai Jagadisha Hare. Thank you, Mataji.
Okay, can I go? This is Genevieve.
Yes, Genevieve, please go ahead.
Brahmano hi pratishtaham amritasya cha sasvatasya cha dharmasya sukayasya cha. Who is that fighting Hiranyaksha with long snouts now and two sharp curled tusks? Who is that fighting Hiranyaksha? Who lifted from Govardhaka? lift the earth from Govardhan. Varaha Hari Hari Bol. Keshavadita Sokara Rupa. Jaya Jagadisha Hare. Jaya Jagadisha Hare. Jaya Jagadisha Hare.
Thank you very much, Janavi. That was so nice.
Can Garima say?
Yes, Garima, please go ahead.
I know this verse. I know this verse. Can I say the whole verse?
Yes, please go ahead, Garima.
ब्राह्मणो हि प्रतिष्ठाहम् अमृतस्य व्ययस्य च शाश्वतस्य च धर्मस्य सुखसैकान्तिकस्य च. Thank you. Sad fighting Hiranyaksha with a long snout and two sharp curled tusks. Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha? Who lifted the earth from Garbhodakka? Who lifted the earth from Garbhodakka? Varaha Hari Hari Bol. Keshavadritaksha Kararupa. Jai Jagadisha Hare. Jai Jagadisha Hare. Jai Jagadisha Hare. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Garima. That was so beautiful. Okay, Madhav, little Madhav, do you want to go ahead?
Yeah, see. Brahmanohi.
Brahmanohi.
Pratishtaham.
Pratishtaham.
Amritasya. Amritasya.
Amritasya.
Okay, now you see the rhyme. I didn't see that. No. Who's that? Who's that?
Do you want to say the rhyme, little mother?
That's it. Who's that fighting?
Who's that fighting Hiranyaksha?
Who lifted the earth? From Garbhodaka. Garbhodaka. See, Varaha.
Varaha.
Hari Hari. Vararupa.
Rukalayupa. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you very much, Madhu. Okay, Raghav, it's your turn. You can do it.
Brahmanohi pratishtaham amritasya yajya shatasya chadarmasya shatasya chadarmasya. And to swap to good. from the Gavadarka. Baraha, Hari, Hari Bol. Keshava Dita.
Thank you very much, Raga. Okay, is there anybody else who would like to sing the rhyme or the shloka? Please raise your hands or call out your names.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Deepak, can I show my Varahadev? My Narasimha.
Yes, please go ahead. Yeah, I can see it's so beautiful. See the lion there. You've almost tried to do the same as the one given in the presentation. Very nice. Very nice.
Thank you, Mataji.
Can I show my Narasimha as well, Mataji?
Who's this?
Janavi.
Yes.
My Varaha Narasimha Dev.
Yes, Janavi. Beautiful. You've drawn Narasimha?
Yeah.
So many details. Very nice. Very beautiful. Okay.
Mataji, look at my drawing.
Who's this?
Risha.
Neha.
Risha, nice. Risha.
Neha, beautiful.
It's Risha, Mataji. Risha.
Lion. And
Risha is her name.
Risha, okay. Risha.
Thank you, Mataji.
Beautiful. The eyes are so beautiful. And I can see Kavya also. Very nice. Going. Okay. Rala, do you want to go? Garima, did you want to show your drawing or did you want to say something?
Yes, Mataji.
Raise your hand.
Have we already drawn the Narasimhadev or we are going to draw?
We are already done.
There was a picture given in the presentation. See this picture. And accordingly, the kids were trying to draw Narasimha, the lion form. So if you have any other kind of Narasimha also, it's fine. But otherwise, you can send the picture in the group.
So, Mataji, can you
go to the 12th?
Okay, yeah.
How to draw?
We send this picture in the group. Right now, we are having the next class coming. But you can ask your mom to give her phone. So in the WhatsApp, I send these steps. So you all can sit and do it in a little bit more time, you can take it.
Hare Krishna Mataji, my mom doesn't have Bhakti Sangha Japa group. My dad only has it.
Okay, you can ask your dad's phone, okay?
Okay, Mataji, thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna.
No worries. Please, after finishing, you upload it, okay?
So, Mataji,
we can conclude the class, Mataji. I would like to offer my
We can conclude with the
Vancha
Mataji ki.